Is there an association between the levels of glycemic disorders and cardiac abnormalities, such as left ventricular hypertrophy?
Well, I think we have enough evidence today, both from an epidemiological, experimental level, and also some clinical level, that demonstrates that there is some correlation between the level of severity of diabetes and of glycemic level and the development of cardiac abnormalities, such as left ventricular hypertrophy, left ventricular dilatation, the dysfunction, diastolic dysfunction. And we can actually see that at early stages of the process. There is a very recent study that looked at four different types of patients, and it showed that in the patients who were at the early stage that started with their diabetic process, they had more abnormalities than the ones that developed diabetes at the later stage, demonstrating that there is probably a correlation between the levels of exposure and the time of exposure to the to the high glycemic levels, and also insulin intolerance and the development of cardiac disease.
What is the role of metabolic exposure, like diet, obesity, physical activity?
That's a very important question, because we still don't know a lot about all these correlations. We do know that the majority of patients with diabetes, they have other disease processes. They have hypertension, they have diet changes, they have obesity, they have many concomitant abnormalities that may actually be also responsible for some of the differences and changes that we can observe in these patients. However, we still don't have enough data and enough studies, I mean long-term studies, that have studied these patients from early stages to later stages and try to understand a little bit more what is the contribution of these different, what we can call the exposome of these patients, which this metabolic component that still needs to have further data to help us to understand how is the right importance of each one of these different components. But there is still an open way there for some research.
And today we don't have any preventive therapy for diabetic cardiomyopathy. Are there studies about this?
Well, there has been some, and there are ongoing studies trying to look specifically at these preventive measures. We do have now some new classes of drugs that seem to be promising. We have had a first study, the EMPA-REG, that it seemed that is promising in this setting of patients. There are other targets, other potential targets for therapy, but for the moment specifically we still don't have a therapy that we can guarantee that will be efficient in the diabetic patient to prevent the development of diabetic cardiomyopathy. So it's an open area also for research.